are you? Doesn't matter. Welcome. You're safe with me. I'll be right here, nice and close, so I can speak without alerting the others. Let me tell you about Senua. Her story has already come to an end, but now it begins anew.
What's happening? It's breathing.
Dead.
It's breathing. It's breathing. He knows she's getting closer.
He can feel her coming closer.
She's getting closer.
This is a journey deep into darkness. There will be no more stories after this one.
What is she doing? Why is she doing this?
They're watching.
Why doesn't she tell him? She's doing this for him. She wants to rescue him.
He's already dead.
I can feel you coming.
Shh.
Quiet.
Oh, how rude of me. I never told you of the others. You hear them too, right? They've been around ever since the tragedy. That's not quite true. Some are old, some are new, but they've changed. I think the darkness changed them, just like it changed her.
Can you see them?
He's in Helheim.
Look, up ahead.
Helheim.
You see it too?
You promised you could.
Yes. It is real after all. She's finally arrived in the land of mist and fog. The place the Northmen call Hell.
Can you see them? Can you see them? They're going to do that to you.
They're watching.
Stop. Can you feel them watching?
They're watching her. What is she thinking? I can tell you. She's afraid. Wouldn't you be? You'd think she would get used to it by now after so many years. But the darkness, it just builds onto itself, growing stronger, towering over her. You might try and ignore it. Turn away. But it's always there, just out of sight, where you're most vulnerable. It's like it knows that just enough light is all you need to see its suffocating power. You might think she's brave to go on this journey on her own, but it isn't bravery that drives her. bravery only means something to those afraid of death. Then it was fear, runs far, far deeper.
What is she looking at? What is she leaving behind?
I know what she's thinking. I hear her thoughts. It's not too late to get into the boat and go back. No one will judge her. No one will ever know. Oh, she heard us. There's no going back.
You can't do it.
Senua pushes away a world that conspired to cause so much suffering. There's nothing to go back to, and worse to look forward to. Why don't you join us? Maybe you too have a part to play in this story.
Look really clearly.
Focus, Senua.
Focus. Focus and you'll see.
What happens?
Do not forget my stories, Senua. Because your darkness comes from hell, and your fate lies there. They say the burning of a corpse will take you straight to Hela's gate, but gods and the living will follow this path. You must leave the Isles of Orkney across the Eastern Sea, and find a road that leads north and down through deep, dark valleys. After 9 nights of riding, you will follow a great river and will find a bridge covered in gold. The path to Helheim goes from there, across the river of knives that flows from the dark world of Niflheim. The river of knives across which lies the halls of hell. The place they call Helheim.
He's lost.
Where are you? There's no doubt about it. The source of the darkness is in Helheim. And the goddess Hela holds his soul there. Her dear beloved, Dillian,
back. She's doing this for him. She wants to rescue him.
He's already dead.
He's dead.
His soul is in hell.
The bridge to Helheim. I forget its name. She forgets too. But she does remember that only the dead may cross it.
Northmen speak of nine worlds. The world of men they call Midgard. Sky gods dwell in Asgard. The gods of earth, harvest, wind, and sea dwell in Vanaheim. The good elves dwell in Alfheim. The evil ones dwell in Svartalfheim. The mountain giants dwell in Jotunheim. The fire giants dwell in Muspelheim. Niflheim is the world of ice and darkness. Only the dead dwell in Helheim, and that is where you must travel.
You don't know where you're going.
So brave.
Just calm down. What's the deal?
Stop.
Why did she do that? She shouldn't have done it. She can't go back now.
No, this is it. The hidden path. Stories again, old friend. I'm listening.
The runes seal the gates to hell. Focus your inner eye, and you too will see what's hidden in plain sight.
I can see one.
Hold it in your mind's eye. Find one like it to open the gate.
Use your eyes.
It's near. Look towards the gate, and the gate will open.
The gate is open. Go through the gate.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it. It worked.
I spent 6 years enslaved in hell. But I watched the Northmen. Learned their ways.
I know you did.
You listened? When everyone else laughed. My people paid a heavy price. Carry my stories with you, and together we will make the Northmen feel our fury.
Another voice joins us. She wants to try to make them go away. Pretend they weren't real. Down on the waiting for you to make that little slip. You can't just wish things away.
You can't fall. If you fall, you will die.
The world of the dead is ruled by the giantess, Hela, daughter of Loki. The gods who feared her bloodline, bad on her mother's side and yet much worse on her father's. So, as a child, the Allfather cast her down into Helheim and gave her power over those who die of sickness, age, hardship, and self-slaughter. In all of the nine worlds, only Hela can resurrect the dead.
The living from the dead. Is that the face of Hela herself? The half-rotten goddess that rules over Helheim. Whatever horrors lie behind that door, she must find him. a vision of what's to come. Poor Senua. The darkness does not bargain. It does not reason. It is rot. And now it has taken hold. It will spread towards her head, the seed of the soul, until there is nothing left of her. All of her suffering will have been for nothing. It's just a matter of time. Hardest battles are fought in the mind. That is what Dillian taught her. With every defeat, the dark rot will grow and soon it will take her soul. But for now, at least, she still has control of her mind. And she will fulfill her vow. Whatever the cost.
He's not really.
Listen to me, Senua. The goddess Hela lies behind the gate to Helheim. To open the gate, you must first face the gods that guard it. The god of fire, Surt, and the god of illusion, Van Raven. Spill their blood to open the gate to Helheim and enter the land of the dead.
To Dillian,
to his soul.
The Northmen say that in the beginning there was nothing but darkness. Bitter cold to the north, fiery hot to the south. They say the cold formed ice, which melted from the sparks from the south. The power of the darkness gave life to the dripping ice, and the first giant was born and was named Ymir. The ice continued to drip, and the power of the void gave life to it, and it became a cow whose milk fed the giant. That's right, a cow, but you weren't expecting that. Comes from a land older than mankind. And the Northmen call upon his flaming sword to raise their enemies to the ground. Find him, Senua, and spill his blood.
She found the wretched old fool on her way back from the wilds. Now, come. Badly burnt all over. She took pity on him, for he was not long for this world. Like her, who spoke of his own darkness, the Northmen.
The Northmen tell this story. Before the earth was created, there was a world called Muspel. Because it was in the south, it was bright and hot, flaming, burning. Sparks that flew out from Muspel became the stars. Other sparks melted ice in the frozen world of Niflheim, creating the body of the first giant, Ymir. Muspel is one of the nine worlds, and is now the land of the fire giants. And people from elsewhere cannot endure a journey there.
We each walk these lands, gazing towards different horizons, some of us further than others. Your father cannot see what you see, but there is nothing wrong with seeing the world the way you do.
Human flesh. And I still hear their cries carried in the wind. You hear them too, Senua?
Yes, I heard their screams, and I still hear them now.
The path to Helheim is sealed to the living, but you already walk amongst the dead. Look towards the gate, and you will see that it has opened. When they first came to my lands, I knew enough of their tongue to beg for mercy. Took me as a slave. I wish now that they had slaughtered me like the others. I rode their storm of fire, death, slavery to many lands. This darkness you speak of, I know it well.
And I'm still here to fight it.
He's down. Finish it.
They've surrounded him.
Quick, behind you.
She get through.
She'll need to find another way.
Truth set. Find your own path.
There's always another way.
There's always a way.
Find your own way.
You just have to find
it. The Northmen say that the defender of Muspel is called Surt, the foremost of the fire giants. His name means the Black One, because he is like something burnt. The Northmen believe that he sits at the border of Muspel with his flaming sword. And at the end of the world, he will leave his post. He will travel to Asgard and Midgard, waging war against all the gods. He will be victorious, and then burn the whole world with fire.
Another gate.
She needs to find it.
Another fire sacrifice.
Another fire sacrifice.
Find the fire, Senua. Follow the path to Surt.
It's too far.
She'll never find it. She'll never make her way back.
She needs to remember the way back.
What happens when she finds it?
Everything will burn.
Concentrate. Concentrate on where you're going. She needs to remember the path.
Everything will burn. Then how will she find the way back?
She won't. She won't be able to tell.
The Northmen made fire sacrifices, burning slaves like me to reveal the path to Surt. I searched for meaning in their suffering, in their eyes. But they just screamed like helpless pigs.
Oh, my God.
Answer your prayers, Senua. I asked the gods for mercy, all of them, even theirs. None answered. In the end, I set myself free. Defy the gods, Senua! Find your own path, like I find mine!
My gods abandoned me! I am alone.
The Northmen believe that the world will be destroyed someday. They call it Ragnarok, the destiny of the gods. Asgard will be attacked by Surt and the fire giants. A monstrous wolf will swallow the sun, and the gods will fight in vain against their enemies. There is nothing they can do to prevent it, but Odin ever seeks knowledge and magic, hoping to find a way postpone that dark day. The Northmen of Hell worship the Devourers, insatiable gods of darkness. I come from Erin, Senua, where I once followed my own gods, the Tuatha De Danann.
Why did you abandon your gods?
Senua, I was a man of knowledge, not a warrior. To survive, I did things. Bad things.
Like you, Senua. The man I once was has died. And when that happens, even gods you worship can die with you.
Thank you. The Northmen say that at Ragnarok, the sons of Muspel will travel to battle in the ship called Naglfar, the corpse ship. And when the sons of Muspel leave the ship and ride to battle, it will be as though the sky had split open, and Surt will lead them. Wherever he goes, flame will erupt before him, and fires will burn behind him.
How did you escape your darkness?
Senua, once I found my purpose, I was no longer enslaved to the suffering I had to endure to reach it. Unclouded by fear, I could see it clearly in others. Even my captors feared the fire of Surt. And so, during one raid, I took my chance. Ran, knowing that they would not follow. A fool ran into the fire. They left me for dead. Maybe they were right.
free.
I'm glad I found you in the wilds. I wouldn't have made it without you. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. This darkness takes everything. Everyone.
Senua. Are you sure you want to do this? We can fight this together, side by side. We always do.
This is my battle. I have to face it alone. Away from here.
Where will you go?
I don't know.
For how long?
I don't know.
I believe in you. You know that. Just promise me that you will come back to me. I want you to say it. I want you to say it.
I will come back to you. I promise.
You from the world and forever from the dead.
every battle won, a greater battle takes its place. But so it goes until we fall. And in the end, we all fall. Even the gods have their time. Yet we still go on. Why?
I made a promise. And I will go to hell to keep it.
I die free, knowing you will carry my stories with you.
Truth was a troubled man, a scholar turned slave. They tortured him, took him with them on their raids, drove him to madness, spreading this new form of darkness to new worlds, to my world. Senua saw a deep connection form between the Northmen and the darkness. His tales of hell were true. Then that was the source of it. She learned everything she could from him. Until she too could see what he saw. Of self is shattered. You simply cease to be. Though it may not seem that way to others, you know when it is true. You can feel it. A stranger in your own body. An imposter. And nothing is the same ever again. Senua has died before. She will do so again. You can be sure of that.
Ah!
She can't get through.
Why not?
She must go to the gate.
She can't.
Why?
She's only done one test.
Just one.
She's only passed one test.
What's the other test? Is there another one?
There must be. The gate won't open.
Druth said Balraven.
Balraven.
Dark magic.
Balraven, Druth said.
Balraven. Ancestor of the seers and master of ravens. He hunts his prey with his powers of illusion and feasts on their remains.